I don't think anybody at home has any idea the scope of how many people are being helped here.
Well, every year, tens of thousands of Iowans are feeding, housing, teaching, and treating millions of Africans. But they never get to meet the people they're helping.
Which is why we sent News Channel 8's Eric Hansen and photojournalist Jesse Landolt on an epic assignment to find the remote third world villages being changed by Iowans.
And wait until you see what they found.
Every year, Iowans young and old from big cities and small farms donate dollars and hours to help strangers on the other side of the globe. And we trust it's helping. But we boarded the longest nonstop flight of any U.S. airline, 17 hours each way, to Johannesburg, South Africa, and then headed out to remote tribal villages not far from Botswana and Mozambique for a week-long quest to find the faces depending on Iowa.
If the tribal crowds didn't do it, it was the faces that elicit fear. A realization.
Wow, you know, this is Africa. We're not in the United States anymore.
A land where elephants roam free.
Always be very careful. Look, listen, smell.
Making Iowans freeze while their cannons fire.
There's something really kind of exciting and special about Africa.
Specifically, South Africa.
It is a beautiful country.
Beauty in its creatures and beauty in its simplicity. Like the donkey carts shuttling kids to the party.
A year ago, this was just open field.
A party being thrown by an Iowa doctor.
A white guy from America.
Who's marking a milestone, another feeding center built by Iowans for African kids, like 12-year-old Jacqueline.
I'm leaving with my mother, my brother, my sister, and my young sister.
Who'd all go hungry without Iowa.
He changed my life very much, and he gave me food and everything I need.
Our vision is by a year, at most 2 years, we'll be feeding 10,000 children every day using the rice packets that many Iowans have worked at Ivy Hall and schools and churches all over the state packaging.
That's 10,000 children fed across this country every day. In this one spot, on this one Saturday, the cooks in the kitchen were planning on 1,000, which is why they put a farmer from Boone to work, slicing open the very packages he sealed.
When we package this stuff in Des Moines or Iowa, wherever we are, it's kind of a hypothetical thing. I mean, we have this picture that somebody's given us about where it goes, but to actually come and to see the people and to understand that there's kids here today, that this is the only food that they'll get today. You see, that's impressionable.
For hours, they cooked while those donkey carts kept rolling in with the kids who simply wanted to play and eat.
Only it wasn't 1,000 that showed up. It was 1,500. And that created a big problem.
When the plates ran out, they grabbed cups.
There's hungry kids, and we're just trying to get as much food out as possible.
As quickly as possible, because this sea of kids was waiting for their only nutritious meal of the day.
This puts a huge perspective on it.
And this is just one day in one feeding center. But on this day, there was another milestone.
Now, it's not every day that somebody celebrates a 20 millionth meal.
20 million meals in 5 years, from Iowa to the world. That 20 millionth one traveled to the African village that Urbandale doctor now calls home.
I had a great job, I made a lot of money, and I enjoyed my job.
Dr. Jim Blessman used to work for Mercy Medical Center.
I ran their pain center for 25 years.
Until 8 years ago, when he says God called him to Africa.
Father, we just come to you and we thank you. All my physician peers thought I had gone crazy, and they were very much, they thought I was extremely weird.
After he came to Africa, he really, really wanted me to come, and I just did not want to come. I was really stubborn, and finally I said okay, just to get him off my back.
But within months, the couple used their Iowa connections to start an African transformation. Iowa manufacturers got on board, so did churches and medical schools, and a key for the future, farmers.
Bringing rice from Iowa is a short-term answer. That is not the long-term answer.
For that, check out what surrounds those kids eating Iowa's meals. A field of corn planted back in November, spring here in the Southern Hemisphere.
This year they see our yields and they say, how do you do that? We say, come back and we'll teach you.
We have just started it. It's still in its infancy, and it is touching the community a lot.
Yohani's an African agronomist, determined to make his plot using Iowa techniques, the neighborhood model.
So they really like it, and many people are asking, how can we do it? Can we also do it? So many questions.
And Iowans are feeding them the answers about their gardens and more.
So they could raise a few chickens and again, feed themselves and even sell some.
But education takes time. For now, the immediate help stamped Des Moines fills semi-sized containers and entire warehouses.
That is real, you know, knowing that I know I was there on that day.
When Iowans filled these boxes.
And now it just brings it to fruition that we can see exactly what we did.
Saving the lives of adorable orphans whose parents died from AIDS.
90% of the food that they eat is from Iowa.
And teenagers who play barefoot soccer while their day's only meal cooks over an open flame.
No, they have no enough to eat because sometimes there's no money to buy some food.
Some might look at this land of safaris as just a tourist stop filled with Kodak moments. To the Africans receiving this humanitarian effort from Iowa?
I think it's massive. I sometimes wonder if the people in Iowa realize what the difference this makes in Africa. Remember, when you look at South Africa through the TV, you look and you think, oh, you know what? South Africa is okay. We're not. There's many children that still go to bed without food. It is massive. It's not just something that, you know, you can take just by the way and it has happened. It is a huge impact that this has made in our country.
And that just scratches the surface of what we found in Africa. We haven't talked yet about the Iowa doctors combating AIDS or the Iowa companies constructing homes over there, the Iowans bringing glasses to remote tribes, or the churches sending boxes of love to hundreds of thousands of African kids every year. That part of the story continues tomorrow at 10.
Thank you for this beautiful story. I think that farmer from Boone had it right. Mm-hmm. You know there's a need, so you volunteer your time, but boy, when you see it, it really hits
home. Right. It's faceless to a lot of people who are packing the meals or different things like that, and you just trust something is going over there. But when you see the faces and the cute little toddlers we played with and the elderly, that was pretty neat.
I think it's also impressive how widespread the aid is, if you will.
Yeah.
It's not, I hate to use the term just, but it's not just Meals from the Heartland. Yeah. It was Dr. Blessman and some of the things that you mentioned that have actually been going on for years.
It's companies, it's all kinds of different Iowa entities that have got on board. It's really impressive. And photojournalist Jesse Dwandle got some great pictures over there. Glenn Bierman put it all together, and so we'll continue it tomorrow.
Looking forward to see it. Thanks a lot, Eric.